So I did a 3-week coding bootcamp called SheCodes Basics, and this is a review meets therapy video because I have a bit of a love-hate relationship with coding. So let's dive into it. Hey, my name is Anna and I'm a German mechanical engineer based in Sweden. Despite being an engineer, I never really learned how to code, and I finally decided to tackle that, and my first step was to take SheCodes Basics. So in this video I'm gonna talk about, first of all, my history with coding and why I decided to take SheCodes Basics, then how SheCodes Basics works with the workshop structure, lessons, homework assignments and support, my coding skills after SheCodes Basics, so I'll show you my final project, and then finally if SheCodes Basics is worth it. Okay, so let's start with my history with coding and why I signed up for this workshop. So I actually sort of learned how to code several times before. In high school, I took a computer science class where I learned some basic coding using the language Java, which was fun, but I also sort of felt already behind when I started the class because a lot of people that took it were already super into coding and had taught it themselves. I wasn't very computer savvy and I knew nothing about coding. And to me, it sometimes seemed like the teacher was skipping some essential information that I needed that somehow everyone else just knew. That wasn't the best experience. And then in university, where I studied mechanical engineering, I did have a class called Information Technology for Engineers, where they taught us some basic coding as well with the language C. And there I had the exact same feeling like in high school, that they were skipping ahead through things that I was somehow supposed to already know but didn't. We were also expected to code in MATLAB for some classes, where you basically use code to solve math problems, and to be honest, I never really got into that much either, and I just kind of got by with the bare minimum. I also one time went to this university coding club because I still really wanted to learn how to code. I just didn't feel like I had found the right place to learn it yet. And there they set me up with this free Python online class, and that was a complete flop. Because in that class you were supposed to code this war-themed computer game where, I don't know, ships attack other ships or something like that. And it was expecting you to know a lot about how those kind of computer games work. And I don't play any computer games. The only thing I've ever played is The Sims. And I also have zero interest in war games, like, just, it's just not for me. So I was trying to learn how to code while also having no clue how the thing works that I was supposed to code, and also having no interest in it. I quit it the same day I started it. But I've always felt a bit insecure about the fact that I don't really know how to code, and it's been on my bucket list to finally learn it. And I decided to start with web development for two reasons. So first of all, I heard that it's a great way to understand how coding works because it's naturally really visual, which makes it easier to understand and also just more fun for me anyway. And second, because I really wanted to build a website for myself, and nothing is better motivation to learn a skill than having a passion project that you need that skill for. And so when I randomly heard about SheCodes in a YouTube video, it sounded like exactly what I needed to get started. So I signed up for all of the workshops. Yeah, I signed up for all 4 of the workshops. So now I have to do them all. Okay, so how does SheCodes Basics work? First of all, it's a 3-week workshop with a workload of about 5 hours per week. And I thought that was pretty realistic. Sometimes it took me a bit longer because I was just putting unnecessarily much work into it because it was so fun. And sometimes it took me less time because some of the challenges were easier for me. So it's supposed to be 5 hours per week, but you can always work ahead if you want. So you can do it in 2 weeks or in 1 week if you want. But you can also request an extension on any deadlines if you fall behind or go on vacation or something like that. In the first week, I learned how to use HTML and CSS, which were both completely new to me. I had never worked with them. And then as a homework for that week, I was supposed to build a simple weather website where I was using HTML and CSS. Then in the second week, I learned how to use JavaScript. And then as the homework assignment, I added JavaScript to the weather website that I had built the week before. And then in the final week, we were supposed to focus on the final project. So we basically got to apply all of the skills that we learned from HTML, CSS, and JavaScript and put them all into one basic but already pretty cool website. So I'll just show you what it looks like when you go onto the workshop page. Here you can see an overview of the first week. Each week basically has a bunch of lessons that you're supposed to complete. The first week had a lot of lessons. They were all very quick. And then if you go into the lesson, then you first have a little video to watch and then some resources below. And then you have a challenge that you're supposed to do. For example, here we had to replicate this page. And then you submit your solution and then you learn whether or not you did it correctly. And then once you do submit something, you can access the solution as well. This is really cool because you learn a little bit and then you immediately get to apply it. And the challenge was always just a little bit harder than what you just learned. So sometimes it was necessary to Google something, or you just had to kind of combine two skills that you already learned. And that was really fun because, yeah, it was just the right amount of challenge, I thought. And so, for example, this was week one, and then there's also week two, which had just a couple of lessons, and week three, which basically Matt, the instructor, did an example project where he talks you through his process when he's designing a website. He's first starting with the HTML, then CSS, and then adding JavaScript, doing some finishing touches, and then you get to do your own final project. And then whenever you have a question or you're stuck with a challenge or with your homework or whatever, then you can go onto Slack where you can ask questions for every single week and you get a response within like the next day. And you can also talk to other students. And I actually didn't really need this very much. I needed it one time and then I got a really fast response. And otherwise I was really fine with just the information they gave and then Googling a little bit. And they also provide a lot of helpful resources that are either programmed by them or that they guide you towards. Okay, so now let's talk about my coding skills after SheCodes Basics. So obviously I'm not done learning web development. It was only 3 weeks, but I think it's pretty impressive what I learned in this time. And I'll just show you my final project to demonstrate this. So the final project was to make a website about something that you like. So naturally I made a website about sparkling water because I love sparkling water. And I'll just show you what I did. So I started with building the HTML, which is kind of the bones, I think, of your website. You have your headers and the paragraphs you want to add in, any images, any links you want to put, and buttons and so on. So all of the elements basically that you want to have on your website. And then I went in with CSS to make it look nicer. So CSS is what you use to style everything, to add font styles, to make your button look nicer, to make everything centered like I did here. And I kind of went back and forth between HTML and CSS because sometimes it's not super streamlined process. You realize that, oh, maybe I should add something here. Then you go back to HTML and then you make it again look good with CSS. So that's kind of the work process. And then I used JavaScript to make sure that something happens when you click the button. So that is what JavaScript is for, like any kind of actions that are supposed to happen when you click on something. Probably a bunch of other things that I'm gonna learn in the future, but this is what I learned so far. So now when you click on the button, there's a pop-up. You can type in your name and answer some other questions, and then the website can change based on the input. So basically I am using JavaScript to then override the HTML to put something new, a new text in the header that I made before. I will link the website down below so you can check it out for yourself and just see kind of what's possible after 3 weeks of this workshop. So is SheCodes Basics worth it? It depends, I will say. So for me, it was totally worth it because I really wanted to get started with learning web development and I don't have a lot of time because I work a lot for my engineering job and I also travel every week. And then I also make YouTube videos, which takes a lot of time. So I needed something that makes it as fun and quick and easy as possible for me to get started and keep going. You can absolutely find 100% of the knowledge taught in this class somewhere on the internet for free if you're willing to put in the time and effort for that. But I know that I probably would have stopped after like 2 days if I didn't have the homework deadlines hanging over my head and if I didn't have this clear plan to follow of what video to watch next and what challenges to do and which resources to use. So the fact that I finished this workshop in the intended 3 weeks and that I was able to learn the skills needed to build the website that I showed you, and that I did this next to my full-time engineering job and making YouTube videos, makes it absolutely worth it for me. And like I mentioned earlier, I will be continuing to do SheCodes because I bought all of their workshops. I actually reached out to SheCodes to become a SheCodes ambassador, which is kind of cool. And they gave me a discount code, which I can share with you for 20% off all of their workshops. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss my next SheCodes review video and hold me accountable for actually going through with all of these workshops. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it and I hope to see you in my next video.